Halleluja.
Happy Easter. Thank you for joining in worship here. We are going to have such a time rejoicing in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Let me remind you of an old, old hymn, almost 300 years old, but the message is eternal. Christ the Lord is risen today. Hallelujah. Sons of men and angels say, hallelujah. Raise your joys and triumphs high. Sing ye heavens and earth. Reply, hallelujah. Lives again our glorious King. Where, O death, is now thy sting? Once he died, our souls to save. Hallelujah. Love's redeeming work is done. Fought the fight, the battle won. Death in vain forbids his rise. Hallelujah. Christ has opened paradise. Soar we now where Christ has led, following our exalted head. Made like him we rise. Hallelujah. Ours the cross, the grave, the skies. Hail the Lord of earth and heaven. Praise to thee by both be given. Thee we greet triumphant now. Hail the resurrection thou. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Would you stand together and let's sing together, I stand amazed in the presence of Jesus the Nazarene.
This morning's scripture comes from the book of Luke, chapter 24, verses 1 through 12. The book of Luke, chapter 24, verses 1 through 12. On the first day of the week, very early in the morning, the woman took the spices they had prepared and went to the tomb. They found the stone rolled away from the tomb. But when they entered, they did not find the body of the Lord Jesus. While they were wondering about this, suddenly two men in clothes that gleamed like lightning stood beside them. In their fright, the women bowed down with their faces to the ground. But the men said to them, "Why do you look for the living among the dead? He is not here. He has risen. Remember how he told you while he was still with you in Galilee? The Son of Man must be delivered over to the hands of sinners, be crucified, and on the third day be raised again." Then they remembered his words. When they came back from the tomb, they told all these things to the 11 and to all the others. It was Mary Magdalene, Joanna, Mary the mother of James, and the others with them who told this to the apostles. But they did not believe the women, because their words seemed to them like nonsense. Peter, however, got up and ran to the tomb. Bending over, he saw the strips of linen lying by themselves, and he went away, wondering to himself what had happened. "He is not here. He has risen." Join me in prayer. To the Creator of heaven and earth, and to the giver and sustainer of life, Father God, we are grateful for this Resurrection Sunday, for this Easter Sunday, where we come now, where we can worship you with no limits and no boundaries, because the tomb is empty. He has risen. Father God, because there is no death and the grave has no power, no authority, because he has risen, we too have risen to new heights in you. Yes. We too have risen to new expectations, new tender mercies, new abundances of grace and compassion and love, all because of you. And because of you, Father, and the price that your Son, Jesus the Christ, paid for our sins, you no longer see the guilt-stained bodies that we have, but you see forgiven vessels that have risen to a new height of righteousness, a new height of love and compassion, a new height of glory and forgiveness, because God, you gave your only begotten Son who paid the price so that we may have this right to be your heirs, because the grave is empty. The tomb is empty. Hallelujah and praise be to God. Father, be with us now as we prepare for this worship experience. Bless the word that shall come forth. Bless this worship experience as everyone has come here, not out of fashion, not out of show, but out of a sense of humbleness, a sense to worship you in spirit and in truth, because the tomb is empty. In the name of Jesus the Christ, who is our Redeemer, our Savior, and our friend, amen.
Let's go back to last week. We gathered here with our palm branches and we celebrated and we sang Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna. And today you have seen as you've gathered for service the Orthodox, and today is their Palm Sunday and they're singing those loud Hosannas. And around the world today, the Western Church is waking up to Easter. And next week, the Orthodox churches around the world will celebrate Easter. But as we mentioned last Sunday, things would change, and the Hosanna cry, the Hosanna song would change. And they arrested Jesus, they took him, they beat him, and they accused him. But what was the crime? He healed the sick. He raised the dead. He delivered people from demons. He opened blind eyes. He cleansed the lepers. He was the friend of sinners. He walked on the water and he calmed the storm. And he forgave men and women and children their sins. And the question was asked, should we release him? And they cried, crucify him, crucify him. They beat him, and they took him, and they nailed him to a cruel cross. How beautiful some of the gold and silver crosses are that we wear, the beautiful wooden cross here. But it was an old rugged cross that we sing about. A cruel cross, where they pounded the nails in his flesh, and all those around heard him say, Father, forgive them. It was a new message. People who tortured, but he said, forgive them. And then he cried out, it is finished. And all of the minions of hell, the powers of Satan, they rejoiced. And they said, yes, it is finished. We've got him now. He died there on the cross, and they laid him in a tomb. And that tomb went quiet as a stone was pushed across the entrance of the tomb. But you know, Jesus, he went and he plundered hell. There were cries that went out in the depths because they had no expectation of what Jesus was going to do. Lo, in the grave he lay, Jesus my Savior, waiting the coming day, Jesus my Lord. Lo, in the grave he lay, Jesus my Savior, waiting. Jesus, my Savior, he
though my heart grows weary, I never will despair. I know that He is near through all the stormy past. The day of His appearing will come at last. He lives, He lives, my Jesus lives today. He walks with me and talks with me along life's narrow way. He lives, He lives, salvation to impart. You ask me how I know He lives. He lives within my heart.
Rejoice, rejoice, O Christian.
We've already had our scripture reading from Luke chapter 24. The story of the resurrection as told from Luke's perspective. And how we wait, already knowing the story, but how we wait for this day when we can declare, He is risen. Hallelujah. Christ is risen indeed. One of our readings, and if you've been using the reading we gave you last week in the bulletin, one of the readings came from Isaiah 25, and it says, this is our Lord. We have waited for Him. Amen. This is our Lord, and we have waited for Him. It's a special day, and we have waited for this day to proclaim the resurrection, proclaim the power of the resurrection in our lives. Hallelujah. I'm going to ask all the kids who are present to come up and help me as we share the Easter story with moms and dads and aunts and uncles and grandparents. All the kids come up. I'm going to ask you to be really careful of the communion table. Don't pull on any of the cloths, but just come up and let's gather around here and let's tell the Easter story. I need your help here. We can all get seated. Everybody sit. Yeah, even over here, lots of room over this side. You can sit on the floor or wherever you can get a chance. Oh, more coming. Good, good, good. Did you guys know you're going to be the preacher today? Hey? You didn't expect it. But I'd tell you what, I'll give you a little coaching, and you guys are going to preach the resurrection message to all those folks out there today. This is exciting. This is great. So first off, I'm going to ask you, all right, everybody, make sure your hands are free. Are your hands free? Show me your hands. Hands free? Okay. Now, on your lap, the story goes, Mary and her friends were walking to the tomb. Say it. Mary and her friends were walking to the tomb. And let's do it. Amen. Okay, everybody together. Walking to the tomb. Everybody together. Now, take those smiles off your faces because they were sad. Keep walking, but sad. And with a sad face, even say it, they were very, very sad. So they're walking to the tomb. Say it again. They're walking to the tomb. They're getting closer. And then they stopped. They looked. Everybody. Everybody. They looked. They looked. Not everybody's looking, not everybody's searching. They looked. They looked. And they were surprised. Everybody with a surprised look on your face and say, they were surprised.
They were surprised.
Why were they surprised? The stone was gone. They stood there and they looked, and the stone in front of the tomb where Jesus had been laid, it was gone. Where's the stone? Ask the person next to you. Where's the stone? 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 And now they began to run. No more walking, they're running. They went faster, they went faster, they went faster, all the way to the tomb. And then they stopped inside the tomb and they looked around. They looked. They searched. They looked. One more time. They went looking. Are you guys looking over there? They went looking and they looked really, really hard. And then suddenly they screamed. Oh! Why did they scream? Yes, that's right. They looked and Jesus wasn't there. But they saw the angel. They saw an angel and they were so surprised. And the angel asked the question, what are you looking for? Ask your neighbor, what are you looking for? 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 And Mary and her friends, they said, we're looking for Jesus. Say it. We're looking for Jesus. We're looking for Jesus. But then all together, Mary and her friends, they said, but Jesus isn't here. Say that. Jesus isn't here. And the angel said, that's right. Jesus isn't here. Are you ready? Now everybody, don't stand up, but just get almost standing up. Almost standing up. Early in the morning, the women went to the tomb. And they found that the tomb was open. The stone had been rolled away. Maybe she needs a mic. And they wondered. The kids today have expressed some of those faces of wonder, of amazement. But have we come this morning with hearts filled with wonder? The wonder of Christ. The wonder of the stone that was rolled away. As they approached that morning, they saw that the steel that Pilate had put on the tomb, it had been broken and the stone was moved. The Roman guards had been placed there to guard the tomb, but yet they were not seen. And the stone was rolled away and the tomb was empty. It was open. And they find the wonder of the empty tomb. They found a tomb that was neat and tidy and quiet. But it says they did not find the body of the Lord Jesus Christ. Here Jesus was buried, but now the tomb was empty. The linens that wrapped him were there, but Jesus was gone. O grave, where is thy victory? And then there was the wonder of angels. Immediately when I asked, what did they see? The kids already, they were saying the angels. They didn't see Jesus, but they saw the angels. And we need to sense the wonder of these two that came in clothes that says gleam like lightning, that stood beside them. In coming to serve Jesus, even in death, they were privileged to see the angels. They didn't come expecting to see them, but they got that blessed visit because they came to serve Jesus. And you know, every dark place, every lonesome grave becomes lightened when Jesus' presence has been there. And the glory of the resurrection life is first seen in the grave of Jesus, proving he is alive, he is not here. And then the wonder of the message that we've been repeating in song, and we've been repeating to each other, He is not here, He is risen. Hallelujah. He is not here. All the powers of earth and hell have failed to keep Him. He is risen. All authority in heaven has been given Him. And these angels remembered the words that Jesus had spoken and reminded those disciples what Jesus had said. How easy it is sometimes to forget what the Word of God says. And in our times of need, we seek counsel somewhere else, but we need to take counsel from the Word of God. What has Jesus said? Every Sunday I come to worship, and I come with a sense of wonder that the God of heaven so loved the world, so loved me, so loved you, that He sent His Son to die on the cross as a sacrifice once for all, for you, for me, for all of mankind. And the wonder continues as I think of the stone that was rolled away, the empty tomb, of the angels giving that message once and for all, He is not here, He is risen. There's no grave marker that shows the place where Christ has been buried, because He is risen. And every Sunday ought to be a celebration of that first resurrection. Every Sunday ought to be clothed in wonder of all that God has done. Hallelujah. And it's in a similar sense of wonder that we approach the communion table. Altogether, we do not presume to come to this your table, merciful Lord, trusting in our own goodness, but in your unfailing mercies. We are not worthy that you should receive us, but give your word, and we shall be healed. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Is the Father with us?
He is.
Is Christ among us?
He is.
Is the Spirit here?
He is.
This is our God. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We are His people.
We are indeed.
It is always right and proper that we should at all times and in all places give thanks to you. Therefore, we honor the risen Savior, singing,
He is Lord, He is Lord, He is risen from the dead, and He is Lord. Every knee shall bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. He's my Lord, He's my Lord, He is risen from the dead, and He's my Lord. Every knee shall bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. On the same night that He was betrayed, He took bread, and He gave you thanks, and He broke it, and He gave it to His disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Amen. His body was broken for us. And in the same manner, after supper, He took the cup, and He gave you thanks, and He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. Amen. We are our brothers and sisters through His blood. We have died together we will rise together, we will live together. And now, Jesus, as Jesus taught us, we pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
You are my King, Jesus, you.
Christ, King of kings and Lord of lords, he's our King. He's our Lord. Say it. Our King.
Our King.
Our Lord.
Our Lord.
We have so much to be thankful to him for. Are you blessed today?
Yes.
Amen. May the God of peace, who through the blood of the eternal covenant brought back from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, that great shepherd of the sheep, equip you with everything good for doing his will. And may he work in us what is pleasing to him through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be yours now and forevermore. Amen. Amen. Go rejoicing. Christ is risen.
Amen.
Amen.